Good morning, students. Today we are going to solve mental maths. The first problem is observe the pattern in the first division statement and complete the table without actually solving the problems. The first statement is given 69 divided by 10 is the quotient will be 6 and remainder is 9. We have to observe this pattern and fill these two blanks. When 432 is divided by 10, the first two numbers, that is 43, will be the quotient and 2 will be the remainder. For 3-digit numbers, first two numbers will be the quotient and the last number will be the remainder. Here 29 will be the quotient, 7 will be the remainder. Here it is 2-digit number, so first number is the quotient and the last number 9 is the remainder. Next, complete the pattern in the first 3 division statement and complete the table without actually solving the problems. Here the pattern is given, we are going to follow the pattern and then fill the blanks. 592 divided by 100 is the quotient is the first number and the remainder is last two numbers. Here also the same, 3 is the first number, so 3 is the quotient and 71 is the remainder. When we actually divide them, we will get these as the quotient and these as the remainder, but for 100 we no need to divide them. Without dividing we can actually find the quotient and remainder. In 4-digit number, the first two numbers will be the quotient and last two numbers will be the remainder. Here also we have 4-digit number, the first two numbers will be the quotient 80 and the last two numbers 28 will be the remainder. Here also we have 4-digit number, the first two numbers 99 will be the quotient and the remainder also will be 99. Here it is 3-digit number, so first number will be the quotient and last two numbers will be the remainder. For 4-digit number, first two numbers will be the quotient and last two numbers will be the remainder. The next question is observe the pattern in the first 3 division statements and complete the table without actually solving the problems. Division statement, quotient and remainder is given for first division statements. 4348 divided by 1000 is the quotient will be the first number and the remainder will be last three numbers. Here 6209, the first number 6 is the quotient and the last three numbers, that is the remaining numbers, is the remainder. Here also we have 4-digit number, the first number 1 is the quotient and the remaining numbers is the remainder. Here also we have a 4-digit number, so the first number 2 is the quotient and the remaining numbers 940 is the remainder. Next, observe the pattern and fill in the blanks. 9 divided by 3 is 3, 90 divided by 3 is 300, 900 divided by 3 is 300, 9000 divided by 3 is 3000. You can see that the dividend increases and here the quotient also increases. As dividend increases, quotient increases. These are the dividend, this is the divisor, these are the quotient. As dividend increases, the quotient increases. Now we are going to fill this. 24 divided by 4 is 6, 6 fours are 24, so 6 is the answer, 6 is the quotient. Here 240 divided by 4, the number 24 remains the same but we have added 1 0, so add another 1 0 in the quotient, so the number will be 16. Here 2 number is added, so we have to add 2 zeros to the quotient, so the answer is 600. Next, 9000 divided by 3 is 3000, 9000 divided by 30 is 300, 9000 divided by 300 is 30, 9000 divided by 3000 is 3. You can see that divisor increases. If divisor increases, quotient decreases. Here the divisor is going on increasing. The divisor increases, the quotient decreases. The next question is write true or false for these statements. The first statement is an even number never leaves a remainder when divided by 2. The statement is true. All even numbers will be exactly divided by 2. There will be no remainder. So the statement is true. For example, let us take the number 18. 9 twos are 18. So the number 18 is an even number. When we divide an even number by 2, it won't leave any remainder. So the answer is true. The quotient is always less than the divisor. The statement is false. That is, the quotient will be greater than divisor. So the statement is false. Quotient will be always greater than the divisor. Let us check. Let us divide 35 and 5. I am going to divide 35 with 5. 7 fives are 35. 35 minus 35 is 0. Here 5 is the divisor. 7 is the quotient. 7 is greater than 5. That is, quotient is greater than divisor. So the statement is false. Next, 0 divided by any number is equal to 1. The statement is false. 0 divided by any number is equal to 0. A number divided by 1 gives the same number. The statement is true. Any number divided by 1 gives the same number. When we divide any number with 1, we will get the same number. So the statement is true. A number divided by itself gives 0 as the quotient. The statement is false. A number divided by itself. For example, if we divide 5 with 5, the quotient will be 1. Here the quotient is given as 0. When a number is divided by itself, itself means the same number. A number divided by itself gives 0 as a quotient. The statement is false. The quotient will be 1. So the statement is false. Next, we are going to fill the blanks. 24 divided by 1. We are dividing 1 with 24. We will get the same number 24 here. When we divide 1 with a number, we will get the same number. A number is divided by 49, the answer got is 0. So the number divided should be 0. When we divide any number with 0, we will get 0 as the answer. We have divided 67 with the number. The answer we have got is 67. So it must be divided by 1. The seventh question is, check the correct operation to solve each of the following problems. The first problem is, a fruit seller has 985 guavas and 615 apples. How many fruits does he have? How many fruits does he have means we have to find total number of fruits. So we have to add the two numbers. So the correct option is plus. We have to choose the operation plus to do the problem. We have to add two numbers, 985 and 615. 5 plus 5 is 10. We have remaining 1. 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. Again we have remaining 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 plus 6 is 16. So the total number of fruits is 1600. Next, Raghu bought 60 marbles for rupees 180. What is the cost of each marble? We have to choose the operation from here. 60 marbles rate is given as rupees 180. We have to find the cost of one marble. If the cost of many numbers is given and we have to calculate the cost of one, we have to do division. If the cost of many numbers is given, then if the question is asked for one, we have to divide. Divide 180 by 6. We will get 60 into 3 is 180. So the cost of each marble is 3. When we divide 180 by 60, we have to put quotient. In quotient, we have to put 3. 3 into 60 is 180. So the answer is 3. Cost of each marble is rupees 3. Next, Namita bought 6 crates of eggs. How many eggs did she buy if each crate had 4 dozen eggs? Namita bought 6 crates of eggs. In a crate of egg, there are 4 dozens of eggs. Dozen means 12. Dozen means 12. In a crate, there are 4 dozens of egg. The operation we have to choose is multiplication, because it is the answer is given for one crate. We have to find for 6 crate. If the answer is given for one and we have to find for many numbers, then we have to multiply. So the operation here is multiplication. In one crate we have 4 dozen eggs. 4 dozen means 12. So we have to multiply 12 and 4. 12 into 4 is 48. In a crate we have 48 eggs. We have to find for 6 crates. So we have to multiply 48 and 6. 6 eights are 48. So write 8 here and 4 is remaining. 6 fours are 24. 24 plus 4 is 28. So the answer is 288 eggs. Dozen means 12. In a crate we have 4 dozen eggs. So we have to multiply 4 and 12. 12 fours are 48. We have to find for 6 crates of eggs. So we have to multiply 48 and 6. 48 into 6 is 288 eggs. Thank you, students.